Right, let's go live then, shall we? If you're watching this on YouTube, then if you want to watch these live rather than the post recordings, then follow the link in the description to the Twitch channel. But feel free to skip forward to where the action actually starts. Only a few moments of me just welcoming people in and getting set up, etc. But we'll be going sooner rather than later. I just need to tweet out the stream. And hopefully we can get some people in here to watch. It's the Baku Grand Prix today. Azerbaijan Grand Prix in Baku. Decent season so far, so hopefully we can continue that. Let me just tweet the stream out. Spelling Azerbaijan, right? I am. Hey guys. Just behind Fernando Alonso in the league battle. I'm good, thank you, Dirk. Glad you're enjoying the FIFA 19 content on the YouTube channel. I hope you're well as well. Boom, 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 boom. Hopefully my webcam doesn't mess me around today. Hey CJ, hey Josh, hey Luke, hey Joe, hey Willa, hey Lewis, hey Luke, you just finished Singapore on 100% length. Oh boy! Everyone in real life just did that as well. Everyone but Esteban Ocon, sorry, did that in real life. Shall we? Baku, 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 Baku. I need to change my alerts, really, don't I? Thank you, Saul, for 41 months in a row. My man. Thank you, mate. 41 months, bloody hell. You just finished the first season today. Where did you start, CJ? I can't remember what team you started at. Was it Selba? Regardless of where you started, what are you doing at the end of the season? Are you going to stay with the team you're at, or are you going to move? It was Selva, I thought it was. Well, he told it was, but I wasn't too sure.
Okay. We had the new parts come
through. Oh, good. We'll get them on the car and head to SP1. Lewis, with the 12 months in a row, welcome to the 1 year gang. Thank you, mate. You've got your new 1 year subscriber badge in chat now. Keep up the good work, my man. Kill it on the YouTube scene. Thank you, bro. Right, let's see what's gone on the car then. Oh, it's the wear stuff. Weather is all the races going to be mixed. I don't like that. We had a mixed race in China, of course, last time out. It's going to be dry throughout qualifying. It's going to rain heavily at the end of the Grand Prix. Oh, that's going to make things interesting. Now, Baku is not my strongest circuit, I have to be honest. My contract value right now is pretty much dead. We need to negotiate new contracts as soon as possible, and I believe I get to do that at the end of this Grand Prix weekend.
Remember to select a driver that you consider your rival from the rivalry screen on the workstation. Performing well against your rival can
didn't
earn you
quite save that from last
better
time.
Terms when it comes to our contract reviews. You can see a list of eligible drivers to declare as your rival. The more challenging they are to beat, the more the paddock will respect you for succeeding. Just be aware, you'll lose the same amount of respect if you come off second best. So it may be wise not to be overly ambitious.
Well, we did select Kevin Magnussen at the end of the last stream, but obviously it hasn't quite saved that. But he's the only option I have as a rival, so it is what it is. And he's actually been doing a lot better than me. Right, let's go to Let's go to practice first.
Me, this is probably what I'd invest in.
I recommend investing in the chassis. My morale modifier. Oh, chassis team aren't happy with me, evidently. Aerodynamics team are happy with me, as are the engine power team. And the durability team, but the chassis team are disappointed in me. Crudy Jr. with the 16 months in a row. Thank you, mate. I think let's wait until after practice. I'm going to wait until after practice. I think the chassis is where we go next. Chassis and powertrain, because aerodynamically we're doing all right. You can see poor morale in this chassis team. I mean, chassis, powertrain, how much is that? 520. I can do both that and the chassis. I think I'm going to do that, you know. Let's upgrade the chassis. And let's upgrade the powertrain. And we'll hope that they pass. If they don't, then ouch. But they should do, hopefully. Hopefully. FIFA 19 demo should be out on both consoles already.
Welcome to the Baku City Circuit, where practice for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix is about to get underway. This is a technical circuit which will nonetheless see some huge speeds with a near flat-out final sector that's twice the length of Shanghai's back straight. Let's see who can find the right balance in their setup today.
Flying piano lid, Toby, with a 35 months in a row.
Anthony Davis,
heroic behaviour.
Sure,
thank you, mate.
Take us through.
Contract extension confirmed.
We seem to be having some software issues at the moment. Sit tight for a few minutes while we reboot some things, okay?
Whilst we reboot some things. Okay, great. Cheers, then. Right. Let's try and get some extra points, shall we? Thanks for streaming on your 22nd birthday. You're welcome, Danny. Also, happy birthday, my man. Happy 22nd birthday. Skip the repair time, and then we'll go straight out and do these.
We have a number of programs to run during these practice sessions. You can check the details in the car monitor. We'll get good data for both the race and factory teams, so they're well worth running.
I'm glad you enjoyed the video with Niran. That was a lot of fun to record. It's been a while since I played F1, so it might be rusty. Rephrase, will be rusty. This is not going to be a strong circuit for us. With regards to just McLaren in general, because we don't have much engine power. So this is going to be an issue for us here. We're going to be so vulnerable on this straight. And I don't know the circuit that well either. Even this track acclimatisation is probably going to be quite frustrating for me. And there's a lot of 90 degree turns as well. It's going to be interesting with traction too, but hopefully we can deal with it. Probably avoid the curve there on that one. It wasn't really fast enough through there, although it went purple, so maybe it was. Castle section coming up after this right hander, which we can cut slightly. Not back two through the castle section. And 17 months in a row for Nick. Thank you very much. That Baku straight is horrific in the McLaren, by the way. Yeah, we just mentioned that, and I have a funny feeling we might be very much correct, but we shall wait and see how things go. Thank you for the resub, though, my man. Oh, this is a corner I always tend to struggle with. Getting the right exit onto this straight is important. too, and I'm not normally very good at doing that either, but we're doing alright so far. Cross the line! Nice. Return to garage. Well, that one was decent.
I've had a chat with Carl about the new parts, and we're happy that they've been integrated into the car okay.
That's good news.
With any luck, you'll be able to feel the improvement, so give them a try.
Will do, Jeff. Let's go out and do the time management one, shall we? Oh, thank you for the retweet, Aaron. I'm not sure if you're in here. If you are, I don't know what your Twitch username is, actually. Regardless, thank you for the retweet, my man. Time management is something I'm not very good at all, so here we get on. Time to start Season 2 in what is now a fairly struggling Ferrari team. Oh, Jeep, she got moved to Ferrari at the end of Season 1 from Sauber, GG. Well, I guess Sauber is kind of the obvious stepping stone, isn't it? Nice work, CJ. Avoid the curb there, it says. Maybe even just click the curb slightly to help rotate the car. I'm just going to have to be careful on traction in there. I wasn't looking at the chat then. Scrape the ball. Man like Pieface. Hello, mate. Are you alright? How's it going, Jack? You good? My server goes 220 miles an hour down that straight in Season 2 of the Slipstream. Bloody hell. Dan with a tier 3 resub 17 months in a row. Hi, all. Thank you, mate. Thank you for the tier 3 resub. That's very kind of you. Ended up with regular points finishes in the Ferrari for me and Leclerc. Think I just done the right upgrades. Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah, boy. Oh, I think you mean Sauber. Ended up with regular points finishes in the Sauber for you and Leclerc. You just done the right upgrades. Oh, and then you've just acknowledged your own. Yeah. I know what you meant. I don't like this castle section, not on a pad. Your boy is going to have to do a number of flashbacks throughout the course of this Grand Prix, I think. From walls. Thank you for the donation. I'll check that in a moment. Let me just finish this lap. Oh boy, the wall. Here we go. Hopefully we can not scrub too much speed off through these turns and keep the tyres okay. There we go, we're going to be able to do it. And purple too, it's very rare that I'm able to do that. Thank you for the 100 bits, Nick. Starting my teacher training course tomorrow, bricking it. Best of luck, my man. Ew! That'll do, thank you. It's been a while since you watched me. Oh, I appreciate you coming back, Summer Games. I'm good, thank you, mate. Very good indeed. Let's quickly check that donation. Log into my Streamlabs. I should really log in before I do that. £15 from Adam is a G. Keep on smashing, man. Thank you, mate. I appreciate that. I shall try and continue on smashing. Thank you, bro. That's very kind of you. We just smashed that practice program, so let's see if we can continue that on further forward, shall we? We've got next, fuel management. This one, fuel management basically is a case of just gunning it for the majority of that. And then rolling over the line and saving as much fuel as possible. Yeah, I can see the bits in chat on it. That's the only thing. I can see the bit, but obviously in... I don't know. I have the chat open in front of me in my stream rather than Streamlabs. Oh, no, this is where it stays in stand, isn't it? Okay, it's just lifting coast. Just catching that apex turns the car really nicely into that turn. Remember that. I got that completely wrong. That's going to happen a number of times throughout this Grand Prix. But... oh, well that didn't help, did it? Throws you forward a few frames before you get the chance to actually react to what's going on. Thank you for the host. Oh, wide, very wide, very wide. You know what? I'm going to restart this one. Kiki with the raid. Thank you very much, Kiki. I appreciate that. What time is it in Australia if you're just finishing your stream now? Bloody hell. You've been streaming till like the early hours. Thank you for the host though, Kiki. It's very kind of you. The self-proclaimed cutest streamer on Twitch. Who am I to disagree? It's 3 a.m. I thought it was something like that. Thank you for the host. And there we go. There's the first Kiki D-Log me in the chat. I was wondering how long it would take. Kiki's the first female YouTuber or streamer I've met that is the right height. The tallest, self-proclaimed cutest Twitch streamer, and might well be the tallest female Twitch streamer out there as well. 6'2". So far off the delta here, what on earth is going on? Concentrate, Ches. Don't like the castle section. Don't like it! The temptation is to really try and cut that first turn. Still 3/10 down on the delta. Oh, I've got the exit there better than I have done previously. And there too. Can I redeem the delta enough to be able to then coast over the line? I don't think I'm going to be able to, am I? Let's retry again. I will get this. I'm determined. Thank you for all the hosts, guys. Thank you. Have any of you in the chat actually been to Azerbaijan? I don't know as I know of anyone that's ever been to Azerbaijan. Whether it be for their Grand Prix or not. It's not the go-to tourist destination, I'm fully aware. 2 tenths down after just 2-1, I know. Maybe needs to be better through there. Say, this isn't my strongest circuit. It might be a case of just sacking off this fuel management one if I can't do it. Not quite fast enough. Or good enough for the fuel. We nailed the other two though, so. I normally don't get purple on tyre wear actually, so. It's weird, the car just doesn't want to slow down for that one. We talk about it's been almost better than Azerbaijan. You spend all your spare time on a bloody plane, judging by the past month. So close on the delta, although I didn't necessarily have myself through there. If I can get this one right, accelerate early. Come on, drop that delta. There we go. Oh, I got a bit of wheel spin on exit. I'm going to try that one again. Planes are cool. Planes are cool, but probably not when you're on them for like 30 hours. Like. 30 hours at a time, like FIFA has been for Gamescom and then the capture. No, going wrong again. To be fair, at least for capture event, you had a direct flight from. You had a direct flight from Heathrow to Perth, rather than having to like change to Dubai or Singapore or Thailand or something. That's better. Right, let's gain as much as possible down the straight. I don't think I'm quite going to have enough delta to be able to ease off the throttle at all, though I'm like pretty much on my own. Can I save enough fuel in the half attempt I've got? I don't think so. Oh!
That lap was no good.
Nearly.
Need to improve on that.
Nearly. I'm going to return to the garage. We'll sack that one off. ERS management, this one's probably easy enough to do. I like flying. I've never flown longer than 12 hours to LA. And that flight, if you're in economy, is a bit... Well, it's not fun if you've not got enough leg room. Although, to be fair, we could upgrade slightly to economy plus. This year and it was more manageable. But no, our flight to like Cologne was an hour. Gamescom was an hour, Berlin was two, rather than both being like 24 hours plus for you guys. Now number. Subscription, I will check that in a moment. Get on the straight. I hate that chicane. It's a tier 2 sub from Mixed. Try my flight. New York to LA to San Diego. Oh no, to Sydney, sorry. New York to LA to Sydney, 19 hours. Yeah, I think Kiki has you beat there, to be honest, Sam. that Jared was on planes for like nearly 30 hours, or at least travelling for nearly 30 hours. Not quite able to do it. Well, I might as well keep going now.
You're using up too much energy over the lap? Use less intensive deployment modes to maintain more charge.
Terrible idea. Cologne to Frankfurt, Abu Dhabi to Melbourne to Paris. Oh, hello, Kerb. You alright? Ahead, we're having a competition about who suffered more on a flight. I know, right? I think it would be worse if you'd... Like, and I guess, Sam, at least we were in the privileged position of not having to pay for the flights. You pay probably a lot of money for the privilege of sitting on a flight for 19 hours at least. And my flights and Kiki's flights to Cologne and Berlin were paid for by EA. So close to the wall there. Oh, back end. You know what? I'm going to sack this one off as well. Oh, not restart session, return to garage. Southampton to Jersey, 24 minutes. Nice. Qualifying pace, I'll try that one. This is just, quite frankly, isn't my strongest circuit, so I'm kind of struggling to hit the target times for these ones. I've never flown in first class. Or business. I've flown in economy class. First class or business. There's time, at some point in my life, to fly economy or business. I lose 2/10 immediately in that first corner. I need to figure out how to take the first corner properly. Like that. Ish. Very fast at Baku, I don't think. This is probably going to be a long race for us. Now, China was a long race, but that was because we made a mistake in qualifying and the session dried up towards the end. We missed out the weather. Here, I'm just straight up, flat out, slow. God. Yeah, it's not going well. Okay, And it might just, be because we're in the McLaren. We simply don't have the straight line speed. Retry that one with. Oh, don't even get me started about flashbacks at Monaco. You guys know what I'm like at Monaco with the controller. Embarrassing. Come on, Ches. I literally had the line and then just repositioned my bum on the stick. And then go straight into the wall. What am I getting, FIFA 18? I'll be getting FIFA 19 Thursday with early access on Xbox One. I'm just hoping that the Tottenham ground is in it. If it's not, I can't start my career mode until it's been patched in. It's in the day one patch, but I'm not sure whether it's going to be in from early access. I hope it's on the headers that it is. Actually, you know what I didn't do? I haven't put on the custom setup and then adjusted wings. That might help. Setup.
We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car.
Well, let's try 3-5 wings here. 3-5? 2-4? Let's try 2-4. Let's try 2-4 wings. Quickly skip the repair time.
I know it's tempting to focus entirely on the race, but we should put a bit of time aside to run the qualifying sim program. Try to run it before the end of FP3 if you can.
You don't have to turn off time finishing, Cirky Willy. As long as you don't double... I mean, if you were still accidentally, like, muscle memorying it from driven low last year, then yeah, turn off. But if you're not wanting to use it, quite simply just don't double tap the button and it will count as a normal shot. Braking is not anywhere near as good, but... I don't like this setup. Let's go 4-6. I can't use hot lap mode because it's a practice program. Okay, so I can't change it. Jeff here, can you stop cutting the corners?
Hurry.
This is Baku. Baku? This is Baku mode. It's the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Let me change it from rich. Or I could put it to standard, but so why would I move it lower? Thank you for the bit, Nick. Do you want me to give you some? No, I'm good, thank you, mate. I like struggling through on my own. Says using a default setup from Ben, but you know what I mean. I like the challenge. Like it's more best way. If I'm successful, it's because of my driving, not because of a setup. I've got no excuses. Setup someone gave me was bad, or like, if I'm fast or I'm not fast. It's quite simply because I am either good enough or not good enough. I don't know whether I'll get Forza Horizon 4. I don't know as I'll have the time to play it, that's the only thing. But there are so many games that I want to get, so many games I want to play, but it's whether I'll have the time to play them. FIFA 19 launch this week. And obviously wanting to continue to stream F1. A little bit of tail off the car in front, but whatever I am doing is minimal.
We're down on our target times, let's try to find a bit more.
Okay. Don't like.
Have set us back a little. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:43.4.
What's the other practice program? Oh, race strategy. Oh, let me just quickly skip the repair time. I didn't like having lower wings. Like the car didn't feel settled at all. I actually was slower with less wing angle. There is a cooldown on the follow-which command, so please don't spam the chat with it. Hey, Charlie. The Fernando probably is, isn't it? Cheers, Marcus. Just come out and put yourself on the apex. I don't mind. Thank you. so slow through that part of the track. Multiple flashbacks throughout the race, just as we have in practice, but
I don't care. I'm having fun.
I shall use that toe, thank you very much. Goodbye. Maybe. Is kinda.
Okay, super job so far. Getting great data. Stay focused.
You drove into me, Fernando. I quite literally went in a straight line. I have an itch. Difficulty set to 100. Difficulty set to 100. Thank you for the watching from Syria, my man. I very much appreciate that. Why? I'm using the controller. The wheel is just too physical for me with my NE. I just quite simply can't do it. Not for 100% race difficult, race length anyway. Could do it for maybe 5 lap length. 25% out of this, but 100% race length, there's no way my body would allow me. Okay. Everyone says good evening, it just reminds me of that vine. Another vine where the guy, like, it's night time and he just like slides on his feet into camera frame, which is like that's all I ever think of whenever anyone says good evening. I'd go to any Grand Prix. I wouldn't think twice about going to Baku or Bahrain or literally anywhere.
Keep it up.
I hate this part. It's so difficult. How much? Surprised at how much an F1 driver loses weight-wise in a race. It's obviously a lot more at Singapore than it is elsewhere because it's so hot, humid, and the Grand Prix is so long. But the race this afternoon. This evening, local time, in Singapore, the drivers would have lost about 3 kilos in weight just from sweat. because it's like 50 degrees plus in the cockpit.
Super jump.
Yeah, it's normally like 2 to 3 kilos. What if you get thirsty or hungry during your races? They have a water bottle, but they have drivers have their meals planned. Like so they eat according, so that they're not hungry. 1:43.4. So they're not hungry during the race. Thirst-wise, they have a water bottle they can use. Like press a button on the steering wheel, it feeds water through a straw into the, through a tube into their mouths. I'm not sure I'm going to be any good at any of the others, so let's just retire from session.
An interesting practice session there, then. Let's remind ourselves of the top
three. Play with the controller, Smiley.
Ocon, Hamilton, and Sebastian Vettel. That concludes an interesting practice session. Let's hope for.
Sauber don't have a water bottle, except for Singapore. Do they not? Oh,
good
hello.
Day today. Tell us about it from your perspective.
Don't mess up in front of the press.
You really put a lot of effort into practice today. Are you testing new components? You scraped the walls a few times. Were you struggling for grip?
I'm not sure what happened. What? How can my reputation decrease from saying I'm not sure what happened? I couldn't have said the car. If I'd have said the car felt heavy or any of those, none of those answers would have had anything other than a negative influence, I don't think, on one or multiple departments. F1 drivers are some of the fittest athletes on the planet. I mean, people just don't realise. I don't know why my reputation would have gone down there from answering that question in that way. We all quite simply just go to practice 2 or practice 3 just to get the 25 points, 25 resource points.
Quick look at the classification at the end of the session, then.
I can press no comment, can I? Yeah, the video, the recording with Niren and the recording with Jared are both really fun to record. It was a lot of fun. All got a message. Oh, it's just about participation. 100 bits! Season starts tomorrow, but I hope I can catch your streams, mate. Thank you, bro. I'm sure you'll still be able to catch the streams.
As all the cars are now over the line, your top three again are Verstappen, Vettel, and...
I shall have to bear that in mind in future. Pressing B is a no comment. Thank you, Andrew. Four messages? Oh, it'd be expectations, wouldn't it? Make sure you bring the car back in one piece and ideally ahead of Fernando. Well, I'll try. Yeah, it's still going to be rain at the end of the race. It's going to be difficult. I'm not expecting to get out of Q1, but we'll have to wait and see how it goes. Alicia just said that I look slim and she hopes I'm eating enough. Oh, thank you, Alicia. And I am eating enough, don't worry. If anything, I'm still eating too much.
But this is still going to be a difficult session for our drivers as they fight for pole position. Welcome to qualifying here in Azerbaijan.
Thanks. Right. Do I go out now or wait until the end? I might as well go out now and do one lap. I really don't think I'm going to be getting to Q3 at the very least. Or very highest. Thank you for the bits, Mark. Looking like a snack. Bitch, I am a snack. I'm delicious. What did I think of Sorokin? At times, too much, like with Hartley. But as far as we could see from the world feed, with regards to Perez, I don't think he was doing much wrong. He was just defending in a car that is quite clearly just not fast enough for Singapore. It's just not a very good car for the Williams. Desperate times for that team right now. It's really sad. Perez was all over the place today. I don't know what he was doing. When he finally got past Sorokin that first time and just drove sideways into him. Genuinely just don't understand what was going through his mind. I can't slow down for that corner. It makes no sense. That's an ultimate breaking point, I think. I haven't seen any onboards from the Perez-Sorokin clash. As far as you can make out from the live feed, because the next corner was a very, very tight left-hander where he would never have wanted to defend on the inside anyway, because it was like into the tunnel or under the bridge. Oh, I thought it was at a different point of the racetrack. Great. I did see it, Caesar, I just didn't bite.
You've been moved down to P6.
P6 of six laps currently set so far, probably. Excuse me, Roman! Come on, a fast lap. Back away, and half a second down, return to garage. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go out again. Cool. Ultras don't last very long, do they? Bloody hell. Let's wait until the end of the. Let's wait until the end of this session. I'll go out with like 5 minutes to go. Twinkie. So I don't think I've ever had a Twinkie. Traffic. This traffic's gonna just kill my lap. There's like so many cars ahead of me. They just slowed down. What are you doing, Roman? Jesus Christ. Honestly, there's just no room on track. I'm not going to have time to go out again, I don't think.
We've had to spend time repairing the damage to the car.
Yeah, I'm aware of that. Oh. That's it. Out in qualifying in Q1. Slowest of the session. I just had so much. I had like six cars in front of me. There was just nothing I could have done there. We can go faster in the race. I don't think we're even remotely close to being 20th slowest. Hey, Sarah. We might still be able to get points here, especially with the rain. Great. Rotaries are going well, aren't they? And reputation's going to help. No surprise.
Tough luck there. It's not quite where we'd want to be on the grid, but chin up, it's not the end of the world.
Drive fast, don't crash, right, Dan?
Am I right? Exactly.
That's what we shall try and do.
Probably not very well.
We'll give it a go. We'll give it a good old go.
We're almost ready to go.
What can we do strategy wise? It was good rain in the end. It's going
to
be.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going.
So the rain isn't going to come. Personalised isn't much different at all, is it? There's like half a second in it. There's no point needlessly stopping twice if I can avoid it. Before the rain comes. So if I can stop once, and it depends how early the rain comes. Because before it said the rain wasn't going to come till the end of the race, and it came a lot earlier. So I'm going to go for the two stop, even though there's really not that well, there's a significant chunk. I hope that the rain comes a little bit earlier than that second stop. But we'll have to wait and see how it goes. Right, I'm just going to go and use the bathroom.
I need a wee.
And then we'll crack on. So bear with. Let me just run a quick ad break. BRB. Right. I'll just tweet the stream out. I'll show you my assists. The Remoy assists. GG, CJ. I don't need to. Right. How long is it time to finish? How long time does it take to finish a race? It's 100% length, so about an hour and a half. So we should be done. We should be done by like half past ten. I don't want to do for most of that. I need to just turn that off. I'm on Xbox, Broomy. I'm on Xbox. Right, how's the start? Not the best, not the worst. Sorokin got away well. This is going to be carnage into Team 1! Why did it... Okay, I was too busy not paying attention to... Not paying attention to where we were on the circuit. I thought the run down to turn one was a lot further than that. I just wasn't paying attention to the actual track. I'm just going to take it so carefully into T1 then. Can I squeeze up the inside here? Maybe. Hello, Marcus. Oh, there's four places. Oh, hello. Where? Bloody hell, Fernando. I didn't receive Fernando Alonso there. He's just like, all right, I'm here. Fernando's on the outside of me. I'm going to have to be careful here. I don't want to gung-ho. I'm going to have to lose the inside lane here for this next one, aren't I? Oh, he squeezed me right into the wall. He squeezed me right into the wall there. Fernando is faster than you. So you know what? I'm gonna not back out the court quite so much here. And we'll go three wide in there and then we'll make it through. I'm so bad at these street circuits, man. I'm just terrible. Fernando is faster than you. Are you almost done the message? What would we like to feel? Okay, 0.34 of a lap.
Okay, that's a good start. Keep it up.
I hope to. Oh, there's debris on the floor there, I think. Hi, Fernando. Are you coming or not? Yeah. Hi, Fernando. Okay, he didn't go for it. Interesting. just noticed Agassi's on the super softs, which is interesting. He's going to run longer. I maybe should have done that just for track position. I'm not getting an idea, you know. Never mind. My only real chance of an overtake is going to be down the straight at this stage. And then with strategy later on in the Grand Prix. He's defending me well there, yeah. Get a better exit out of the turn onto the back straight, main straight, I mean, whatever you want to call it. This one basically, if I can get a better exit out of here, which I can't do, I'm not as far behind as I was last lap. I don't know whether the ERS is used in time trial. I've not.
You're hitting the energy deployment limit and losing ERS power before the end of the lap. Lower the ERS deployment mode to prevent this.
It's in auto! It's in auto! It's like, you're doing it wrong. You're doing it for me! What are you talking about? I'm not drinking and driving, Dan. I'm pausing and driving. I'm drinking and pausing. Shut up. I'm alright. Thank you for the host.
We think we may see some rain. ETA is about
15 minutes. That's so much earlier than they thought it was going to arrive. Surely not. Surely not 15 minutes. They're expecting it. They're expecting it like lap 35. Not lap 20. It's far too soon for him, isn't it? There's barely any clouds in the sky at the minute. That can't be right. This is about an hour and 40 to finish, is it? Wind up. Hoping with strategy we can get ourselves into the points, but it all depends on when that rain comes. I keep thinking about having a look at here. Stroll has taken sights in front of him. Seen that. Sainz is in 12th now rather than 11th. No. Oh, I thought about it. And he's getting touchy. Not into the castle section. Nope. Backing out of that one. It's most certainly a one car at a time part of a racetrack. The most one car at a time part of a racetrack in any racetrack, really. we've got Sergio Perez right behind me now, who's taken Fernando. Or Cindy right in my back bottom. And I got that wrong, and now I'm going to be a sitting duck on the straight. Right. I'm going down a place or two. Here, I might not even have DRS, I'm probably not going to have DRS, am I? I'm just going to get me before we even get to the DRS. Spot. Bye, Sergio. Bye, Fernando. Oh, don't squeeze me at the wall, lads. Bloody hell. Could like knock each other off the track, that'd be great. Oh, I've got DRS here. It's a right hander next, isn't it? Or is it left? Oh, it's the left. I've got the inside line on Sergio. Fernando's right there as well. Is Sergio going to try and go for that gap? He is. Cool. Still kicking off behind us as well. Someone is going to end up in a wall here. And I have a horrible feeling. Might well be me sooner rather than later. Thank you for the bet. I'm good, thank you, mate. So Checo is still in a McLaren sandwich and still in 15th. It's just that he's behind Fernando and ahead of me rather than vice versa. I'm not sure this next corner is the one to be trying to make a dive up the inside on, but I'm going to go for it. I might have to give that back, or I might get away with it. Looks like I'm going to get away with it. Pretty sure I had all four wheels off the track there. Look, shall we? Yes. That's an illegal overtake. But if I can get away with it, I'll get away with it. Just as a driver would in real life. You're quick, aren't ya? Oh, Brendan Hart is arriving as well. That was a better one. Got inside right. We're leaving racing room and he's going to try and spin me round. I definitely left him enough room there. Yeah, ERS is set to auto. It's just too much on the controller. It's too much to manage. I can't do it. Pay attention, chairs. Oh, I get a warning there for exceeding. I'm going to hit the wall there, so I'm going to flash back. I get a warning there for exceeding track limits, do I? Too busy looking at the cars in front of me and not paying attention to the actual apex of the corner there. See the clouds building, but my tyres aren't going to last long enough for 10 minutes, so I'm still going to have to pit.
Our gap behind is 1.7 seconds.
Great, my DRS isn't working.
There is a fault in the DRS, you won't be able to open the rear We're working on a fix. Stay out.
Some of the front runners have pitted already. Seb has already pit. After just 6 laps, Seb Vettel's been in the pits. Very peculiar. Looks like Kimmy's been in as well, look. At the bottom left of the map. Mini-map. Not sure whether you can see that actually, because the event list. You might be able to. Set blue to my gearbox now. Should have DRS this time, which will help slightly, but I'm still not going to be able to defend against Seb. On the outside of me. What? I was within DRS range there, surely. Lewis coming out the pits next to me. This is for position. Oh, he just drove into me! Son of a bitch. Lewis just straight up drove into me. Talk about fresh traction. Traction on fresh tyres, even. There you go. Daniel Ricciardo right behind me now as well. I don't understand why all the front runners are pitting this early.
Any issues with tyre wear right now. You should have good grip from all yet.
I was certain I was within DRS range of Fernando on the last lap. Absolutely certain. Now Danny Rick's been going for the inside. Well, technically outside now. Look, they're like 4 abreast in front of us. No DRS again! Oh, my DRS is broken, isn't it? Oh, I forgot about that. Thank you for pointing it out, Ion. I just remembered as I glanced at the chat to see your comment. Of all the tracks to have your DRS broken.
We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the super softs.
That's a pit lap 11, I think. Much. We are going to have to worry about fuel at the very end of the Grand Prix. Although if it rains, I should be able to switch down into lean and not worry about it. A safety car would help with fuel. Right, a little bit of front wing damage.
Mind that front wing. It'll need replacing if it takes too much damage.
I this back, okay? Moving in the braking zone, thank you, Brendan. That was moving in the braking zone, that was illegal. That was effing dangerous as well. Watch as we get to, we're in the braking zone here, and he moves to the left as he's braking. Oh, dearie me. Particularly dangerous.
Confirmed, we'll receive you at the end of this lap.
Hit this lap for supers. And they just hope that they last until the rain comes. See the clouds starting to build, but I don't know whether they're going to last. The rain is going to come before my supers go off. Just have to hope. My front wing repair is set to auto, so it should automatically give me a new front wing. Set it to yes, so just to make sure. Tyres won't last for the rain, CJ. I need fresh tyres. Oh yeah, front wing. Cool. No, they definitely wouldn't have lasted. Definitely wouldn't have lasted. Yeah, my brain was on autopilot, and I saw the pit time tick over to like 2.5 seconds. I was like, right, time to go. Just completely disregarded the fact that they were like changing my front wing right in front of me. If the rain comes now, that is the shortest 10 minutes of all time. I'm not related to DJ Wood, no. I just saw rain. Yeah, it's raining. Brilliant. See, the forecast said there wasn't going to be any rain until gone halfway through the race. Not even a quarter of the way through the race yet, and already the rain is starting to fall. The forecast is always wrong. Apparently so. We know that now. My DRS fixed yet? It is, I think it is. Maybe this one is. At least we have DRS as well. I use a pad or a controller, I'm not using a wheel. Excuse me. When the time is to come in for Inters, that's the question. Might be soon. I don't want to jump the gun though, I don't want to pit too soon.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
We're going to try it now. Let's hope that the time it takes us to pit, the rain gets harder. DRS disabled.
DRS has been disabled by the stewards. DRS will be offline.
quite slippery. I may have pitted a lap too soon. Don't backseat drive me, PCD. I'm having to go slow on these inters, but I'm hoping that they're having to go just as slow on their slicks. To mean as well. There's a wary of fuel. A lot of people in the pits, coming out the pits.
Hartley is in the pits.
And it has paid off coming in the pits a lap early. We still had to tiptoe our way round, but we have made up two positions by doing so. Still struggling slightly for traction. Lewis was unbelievable in Singapore. I don't know where that qualifying lap came from. Quality lap is outrageous. Ferrari didn't have the best of strategy calls, no. Not even slightly close to the right strategy calls this weekend. Wrong, sorry. stopping. I've not driven a Porsche car yet, not in a modern F1 car, only in a classic. I hit the wall, that's what happened. I hit the wall. Yeah, the hairpin at Monaco with a controller is always particularly difficult. 400 bits, 300 bits, screw that wall. Yeah, I agree. Thank you for the bits, Zebra. Stupid wall, how dare it get in my way? In a minute in the drive and in the wet. Struggling. Guy who set the time trial record at Monaco put the car in reverse for a second to get it turned in. Oh, really? AI set to 100, Lex.
Okay, the gap behind is 4.1 seconds.
We're pulling away from the Sauber. Pulling away from Ericsson. Struggling to catch Hartley. He's not necessarily rapidly pulling away from me. At the same time, I'm not exactly reeling him in. He's just kind of there. there's been a change in the rain there. At least there's a lot of standing water on the way down that hill. Staying with Brendan Hartley now, but I can't get close enough. At the point, the only real point I have the opportunity to overtake. And through the final sector, I can't stay close enough to have a crack down the straight. Rain is definitely a lot harder now, though. Definitely a lot harder.
Okay.
That in a moment, that's a long message. Pause now. Worth noting that this year heavy rain does not automatically equal wet tyres, you need to ask the weather report. Oh, literally. I think as you were writing that or typing that, I asked about the weather report. And it recommended staying on the inters. I don't know whether the Williams in front is holding up Brendan Hartley, or whether Hartley, if he's able to clear the Williams, is actually quicker than me on pace, and we're only faster than the Williams. Faster than Ericsson, clearly, because the gap behind is getting bigger and bigger. But I don't know if in clear air, Hartley is faster than me or not. Sometimes tyre status is more useful than weather report. Okay. When we get on the start finish straight next, I'll ask about tyre status. See what it says.
I think we're still on the right tyres for the time being.
There you go, look, Hartley's having a crack at the Williams, but it's going to slow them both up, mean they're available to try and attack themselves. Four wets might be worth a crack here. I really don't know. But whether it's just because my rear tyres are not 100% anymore. I am struggling, not struggling, but having issues with traction. Because the tyres are getting hot. Heavy rain for 20 plus laps and it was never wet tyres. Hang on in there until Jeff tells you. Maybe you're new to medium traction control. True. I'll wait until Jeff says something. Hartley and Stroll going for it again.
Gap to teammate ahead is 20.2 seconds.
Okay, so that gap's opened by 1.4 seconds. Since we last heard about Fernando. So I am lapping about half a second slower than Alonso. Now we'll find out whether Hartley was stuck behind the Williams or whether they were both about the same sort of pace. I have a funny feeling Hartley's just going to disappear down the road now. That's all Rosso, but we will find out. Thank you for the sub. I will check the chat as soon as we run this corner. Kieran Features 993 was 7 months in a row. Thank you very much, mate.
Fuel target is plus two. Let's move to mix two or three, please.
Mix two or three isn't going to do anything in the rain, though. That's the thing. Like, I'm just going to spin my tyres up, surely. Yeah, visibility is really bad. Have my ERS set to auto. Hartley's starting to get down the road a little bit now. He was just straight up held up by the Williams. Still pulling away from Ericsson though. surprised at the low speed on the main straight. My Honda was hitting 210. It might be set up. It's going to be... Obviously, conditions are going to play a part in that as well.
A new strategy is available on the MFT.
What's that want me to do? Confirm.
Okay, copy that.
Didn't actually have any sort of tyre strategy there. It was just like, oh, confirming it. Confirming nothing. It's getting real slippy now, though. I think that basically wanted me to take this set of tyres to the end. Because I don't have a pit window now.
Right, we've got people in the pits changing over to full wet. Come in and change your tyres if you need to. Fernando's in for his stop. The pit box is currently full. Stay out on track. Stay out on track.
I'm going to have to stay out. To stay out for one more lap. I hope the end has hurried on.
14.1 seconds.
You know what? Fernando's already out. I'm gonna pit. I'm gonna crash in a bit.
Release. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. Receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over to the track.
Pit entry was just a nightmare. So slippery. See, the others have put another set of inters on. I was recommended to go onto the full wets, and the others are still on inters. Has anyone else gone full wets? Bottas is wets, Verstappen and Leclerc are wets, Gasly's wets, Alonso's wets, I'm wets, and a lot of others around me have stayed on inters, so it's only half the field that has switched to wets. Let's see who made the right choice. Now the race doesn't need a safety car. Not that way. It's hardly going in again. Okay, so some cars pit for fresh inters and are now pitting again. Well, that's drastically improved our race. Cheers, lads. They pit last lap for new inters and then have gone in again then the very next lap for a set of wets, and that has shot us straight up to P13. There's gotta be something wrong with COVID. It's got to be a glitch or some description, surely. Yeah, the game is definitely glitched though. I'll take it. I'll take it. Thank you for 13th place. I feel like I'm just drifting around the circuit right now. Question is, do I change out of lean and into medium or standard, sorry, I'll try it, but I don't know whether that'll just give me too much torque and I'll end up actually losing time. Yeah, throttle management is drastically important, like so very important, which makes it a lot more difficult with a controller. That's where S-Man was 2.1. Still about that, I can pick you that corner. Oh, shut up. Keep an eye on the gap to Brozon. It's about 8 seconds. See if that stays that way or it gets bigger or smaller. This game still isn't bad on throttle compared to 15 or 16, they were horrible. No, I wasn't using medium traction on those games, I suppose, so I can't make a fair comparison. But I did do Baku on medium traction control last year, and this does feel harder than last year. Although again, that was a dry race, this is a wet one, so... Yeah, I'm definitely losing time for those around me when it's wet.
Okay, the safety car is out. We need to form up at a reduced pace. Keep a close eye on that delta time.
What's the safety car out for? A safety car's out, and I don't know why. It can't be because of the weather conditions, surely. It's not gotten any worse than it was the past 10 laps or so. Cheers, Karen. The weather's not gotten that bad, has it?
Slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace.
Our safety car is just waiting.
The safety car is waiting for the leader. You may overtake it. Overtake the safety car.
What a strange race. What a really strange race. Oh, is it because I flashbacked? It might be because I flashbacked. I thought they'd fix that. I thought they'd patch that, to be honest. No, because I hadn't flashbacked, had I? That was the one point I hadn't actually flashbacked, I don't think. Hell? Car just went.
Are you alright? Engine off, engine off.
Is there a mechanic in the game that the safety car will come out if it gets too wet? Is that legit a thing on F1 2018? Obviously it is in real life. But is it a thing in the game? Or will it be because I flashbacked at some point and this is just giving me a safety car? Yes it is. Okay. It might, because I don't think I flashbacked at that particular moment. So it may well just be because of the weather. I might as well put it back in lean and save more fuel, mightn't I? It's taking forever to catch the safety car. I can see it at least in the middle right now. Thank you, Nick. You beat me to it. Ask for a weather report, okay.
This heavy rain will last around 15 minutes, after which we should see a transition to light rain. Fall wets seem like the best tire for now.
Thank you for the host, Will. Still 15 minutes of heavy rain. I mean, it might lighten up before the end of the Grand Prix, as in it might go back to dries before the end of the Grand Prix, but I've no idea. Can you turn down AI driver level during a season? Yeah, you have to do it in between races though. You can't do it in between sessions, I don't believe. You have to do it in between races. Oh, you can change between sessions on PC. No, I guess that patch hasn't come to Xbox yet. Or it might have done. I don't know, I've not played it for a couple of weeks. Oh, he is right. Okay, 1.06.
We've got about 15 minutes of this heavy rain left, after which we should see light rain conditions.
Safety car in this lap, maintaining this speed.
Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap.
Okay.
When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car in this lap.
Well, that doesn't matter, does it? It's artificially slowing me down.
Situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got right now.
Safety car's gone, 21 laps to go. That's 2.3 to Grosjean. Difficulty set to 100, mate. Thank you. Shouldn't have touched the white line there. Shouldn't have touched the white line there. My bad. It doesn't matter if that's a white line or not, I'm still going to pick you up. I think I'm struggling for traction just being a standard fuel mix. Follow each command has a cooldown period on it.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option.
Inters, maybe?
Understood, copy that.
Maybe he wants me to stop for inters. Does want me to stop winters. I'm gonna stay out for one more lap.
Strategy is available on the MFT.
He keeps saying that, but he doesn't actually say anything.
Copy that.
It says a new strategy is available, but it's always blank. Please don't spam the command, guys, otherwise I'll just take it away.
Left of this room. rain, then we think it's going to dry up. 10 minutes.
Hey, Callum. Max Verstappen's going very, very, very slowly. I don't know what's happened to Max, but that could cause an accident. He must have a puncture. Let's have a look. Or just a mechanical issue. He's going very, very, very slowly, and it doesn't appear that he's got a puncture at all. I'm just going to go to the toilet quickly, and then we'll crack on. BRB. Oh, wrong button. There we go.
Ahoy.
Fuel is at target +3. Let's get into mix 3 ASAP.
A little bit of sun's coming through. We might yet get to dry tyres before the end of the race. I set my next tires to ultra, so when it does dry up, I can just dive straight in and switch onto them. Max is still going. He's not retired. Unless he's just maybe not made it back to the pits yet. Have a look. No, he's still going. Looking at the mini-map, I think I've just found Max. I just saw a section go yellow on the mini-map and two cars come up behind a Red Bull coloured dot. And there might be accidents happening elsewhere on the track. I don't know what happened to Max. Some sort of mechanical issue, he just started going very, very, very slowly. He's still here. He's still just... I don't know what's happening.
Trailing our teammate by 19.6 seconds.
Some sort of glitch with Max. He's not pitting, he's just driving around at 10 miles an hour for no reason whatsoever. Well, free position for me. This is the newest F1 game, Lewis, yeah.
Okay, gap ahead is 4.9 seconds. You're doing well out there, keep it up. We're looking at about 10 more minutes of rain. 10 minutes, rain to ease up in around 5 minutes. 5 minutes to light rain. Inters seem like the fastest tyre for now.
I haven't done Monaco yet, no.
We're expecting the rain to get better in around 5 minutes. Light rain in 5 minutes' time.
I'm pretty sure we're going to be dry by the end of the Grand Prix. Just had a race, third one, Verstappen third, smoking Red Bull. The Red Bull being the second worst car in season 2, which is weird. Trust me, I do have to lift that much for that kink in the wet. I'm dramatic. Probably just because it's a train of traffic, but we are drastically catching the group ahead of us. Thought I could make that. We're dramatically catching the group ahead of us, and thank you, Sega. That's what you should have done in the first place. And K-Mag is dramatically catching me behind me as well. Yellow flag, oh that'll be into Max again, presumably. What on earth is going on here? I bet it's Max. Well, this is just a... What is going on? I don't know who I can overtake, if I can overtake. It's just...
Caution.
Oh, it's Max. Well, you know what? Fuck it. If I don't have to give those spaces back, I'm off. That slow-moving Max Verstappen is just ruining the entire race for everybody. I don't understand why he hasn't retired. He's just trundling around at 10% speed. Alonso's currently P6. One thing that's only just occurred to me, though, is that K-Mag is my rival, and we are in front of him. So that's important.
Our gap to the car in front is 13.5 seconds.
Just got to make the most of what the game throws at you. What a peculiar Grand Prix. This is one of the strangest races I've ever had. Oh, is it the pit limit that's stuck on? I didn't look at his wheel. Let's have a look. Yep. Max is stuck at the pit limit. Okay. So he's just driving around at 49 miles an hour.
Excess fuel weighing us down. Set the fuel mix to mode 3. Let's push.
I want to wait until I've got dry tyres before I put it in 3. Not sure if I need to lift that. I feel I need to lift a little bit, but not as much as I was.
The gap to the car ahead is 14.5 seconds.
Sergio is just far too quick. I should be streaming this again tomorrow, yeah. Plan is to stream this tomorrow and a FIFA 19 pack opening. Say Slick's probably left 41, maybe. Left 41, maybe even left 40. Ah, oh, there's Max!
Okay.
Wonder if everyone's gonna destroy him. Early access comes up Thursday. This lap or next lap, chat? This lap or next lap? The drives, I think it's going to be this lap. What do you reckon next? 41. Marcus is going in the pits. There's not just looking for us.
Like some of those puddles are clearing. We're still on the right tyre for the time being, but we're not a million miles away from slick conditions.
He recently watched the F1 2015 right from the field.
Okay, the box is left.
What's this lap for Ultras? There's Max. We'll just say they're both blank. Oh no, there we go. Cam Talbot with the 30 months in a row. Thank you, mate. I mean, that's literally the strategy that I just manually set myself on, for sure. Thank you for 30 months, Cam. Right, the question is, will we go forwards or backwards on dry tyres? I have no idea.
DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. We can't take you right now. Pit in next lap.
Nope. Pit in this lap.
Fernando's in for his stop. The pit box is currently full. Stay out on track. Stay out on track.
No!
Some information on Hamilton. It looks like the problem is terminal. They're retiring.
Lewis is out. Lewis is out. Right, Lewis is out and just gone, completely gone. Lewis is just straight up out the race, so that's another point, another position for us. Hey, Sparky. Held in the pit box for an extra couple of seconds, that really hurt me. P10 at the minute. Time for Rich. Curves. There's Max. That's not Max, it was Williams. Perez is still on Inters. But these yellow flags, well, Lewis is just parked up there, look. I don't know if I can overtake him yet. Now we're in greens.
Green flag.
Move! Perez is on Inters. Is that Glock going slowly? This race has just been glitch after glitch after glitch. But it has meant that we're up in 7th place, 8th place, so I really don't care. Sainz is still on Inters as well. This race has just been all kinds of messed up. I wonder what Fernando's on. Oh, he's on. Fernando and Leclerc are on the bloody podium! What the hell? Fernando's gonna get a podium finish by the looks of things. Oh my god, Max! Max doesn't have his pit limit to run anymore! Hooray!
Right,
now let me through.
Carahead has come in to put on the ultra soft tyre. Carahead is now running ultra softs.
If you'd like to. Oh, I did the wrong command. If you'd like to subscribe, let me find it in the chat, Ben, then follow the link that was put in chat or click on the subscribe button and it will take you to the relevant screen. I don't know, I've no idea. Ah! Now someone else is stuck with their pit limiter on. Oh my lord. I only saw him at the last minute.
Gap to car in front is 2.8 seconds.
Max is just stuck to my gearbox now because he's obviously a much faster car. But he's, how many laps down is he? I can't see. Can't see how many laps behind he is. Bye, Max. And then you'll have to let me pass because the players will come out. He's backing me right, well, he's going to end up backing me right up into, unless he just disappears, into his teammate. Probably going to finish this race 8th behind Ricciardo and Hülkenberg. That's my prediction right now. Thank you. Let's hope the race in Spain tomorrow isn't as badly glitched as this one. Or badly affected by glitches as this one. Don't drive into me, Daniel! He's just going to drive around the outside of me now.
Caution.
Ah! What's Ricardo hit? So Ricardo has hit his teammate who's trying to let him unlap himself. I'm trying to let him lap. Well, that's gone well. Well done, game. I'll have that position, thank you.
Okay, clear.
This race, man. This race has just been all kinds of nonsense. Hello, Nico. Comes the slow moving Williams. Yeah, the pit limit glitch is really strange. I've not seen that before either. Nico's got me this time.
There's 5 laps.
Still though, we should finish P7, which is great. try and hang on to Nico for these next few laps and maybe, just maybe, get him back again. He's on supers and I'm on ultras. Hey Nico, look out. That is exactly a second, Nico Hülkenberg. No DRS, bro. Wait, what? Seb Pitt again. Sebastian Vettel's Pitt again. We're up to P6. What did it? Oh my god, this race. Well, there's two and a bit laps to go then, isn't there, really? I can't believe Alonso is going to finish on the podium. I can't believe I'm going to finish sixth, I guess. Just as important. Williams is just around here, but I can't see where he is. Here he is. That's it. Stay on the racing line, pal. Cheers. He's not going to be. Fernando's not going to be on the podium. He's in P4 now. Fernando's tyres are flying. They're dying even, not flying. Like, real dead. His last lap was 5 seconds slower than mine. Another two laps, and we might well have caught Fernando. Valtteri wins the race. Seb's gaining on me some chronic, but he won't catch me in time. I'm driving for McLaren because that's the team I chose to drive with at the beginning of the season. Seb is right there behind me now, by the way. He has shot up. Where is that gap? We're going to finish somehow P6. Oh, he got held up by the pit of the Williams at the castle. Okay, there.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet.
Oh, Fernando is on the podium. He finished third.
To their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix.
Fernando finishes third and gets the podium. I don't know what's going on with my green screen. Oh, I just moved, apparently. Leclerc and Fernando on the podium in what was, by a long, long way, the most ridiculous Grand Prix of any F1 game I've ever placed.
Valtteri Bottas takes the lead of the Drivers' Championship. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
So we now, actually,
the constructors
actually end up dropping to 9th
in the Drivers. The McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
Charles and Nico leapfrog me. We're level on points with Nico and a point behind Charles. 8 points now behind Fernando after that podium from him. And McLaren are on 50 points in third in the overall constructors. That was just bonkers. Just bonkers. There's no other way to describe that. Bonkers.
Amazing performance out there. You must
thank
be
you.
Happy.
I'm delighted.
Your team must be ecstatic with how you're performing. You were cutting your way through the field during the race. Did you feel comfortable in the wet weather today?
Kinda.
You left a lot of paint on the walls today.
Yeah, I did.
Were you struggling for grip or did you just misjudge some corners?
No comment.
Great. Well, that's everything.
All right. See you later. What was the gap between Bottas and Leclerc? Cheers, Joseph. Actually, despite finishing ahead of Kevin, we're level, losing both rivalries. Finish 8th or better, 400. Quite now, I've done that. Whoa, reputation is flying up. That's good news. Contract negotiation. This is the first time we've had the chance to do this. My value and my contract value were quite obviously wildly dissimilar.
Here we can adjust the terms of our proposal. The more ambitiously we set our targets, the more willing the team will be to give us better perks. We'll have a few chances to suggest a deal, but we need to be careful. If a proposed contract exceeds your value to the team, it will be rejected, and too many attempts will leave us stuck with the original offer.
Okay, so expected qualifying, let's say 15th. What do we reckon? Expected race, 12th, team order, 2nd, team goal, medium. Bonuses, I want to try and get as many as possible. As many as possible. Race bonus. Level 1, level 2. Level two. What do we reckon? Negotiate with a different team? No, I don't want to leave. I don't want to leave my team. I want to stay at McLaren until the end of this season. Why is my green screen just do this? I don't understand. You don't think I'll get that? Good evening, Callum. Right, what should I change then before I offer? What should I change? Tell me what to change. Rather than just saying that's too much, tell me what to change. Just propose it and see. Oh, okay.
We're asking for too much here. We need to make some compromises.
Okay. Get one level 2 per, one level 1 per. You won't get any level 2s. Okay, well maybe if I go for level 1 on everything. Try again.
They aren't coming round to that proposal.
Oh, come on!
Let's try something else.
Right, one attempt left. Should I change the perks or the expectations? Change team goal to hard. Yeah, pit stops don't really bother me, to be honest. Do you reckon that's enough?
Our proposal has been accepted.
Bingo!
The new contract will take effect from the next race weekend.
We did it. That's good. That's nice. I like that. R&D tree, we have 1100 points. I don't currently have a recommended upgrade. Morale everywhere is good at the minute. Yeah, definitely a team effort there. Well done, lads. Still waiting, that's in development. They're not going to be ready till Monaco. I swear at one point we were the fourth fastest team. Rearing out of strikes. I've already done gearbox durability 1. I could do gearbox durability 2. I'd rather not worry about durability though. 1.06 patch made McLaren's chassis shit. Oh, okay. Hi from Quasar. Hi from England, my man. Well, that's still in development, so I can't do anything there. I could develop my secondary wing flaps. Or rear wing outer strakes. Powertrain, that's in development, so I can't do anything there. So to do some more aero, 5% rear downforce, 5% front downforce. I'm quite intrigued. I kind of want to get some more rear downforce, to be honest. And that'd be ready for Monaco as well. I'm gonna do that one. And then I'm gonna do gearbox durability as well. That gearbox is knackered, isn't it? My event gearbox for quali and race is dead. How many am I allowed? Am I allowed another gearbox? Penalty. Prior to completion of 6 minutes with a grid drop. I'd rather not take the gearbox. Well, I'm going to have to. I haven't got a choice, because 66% is a lot. So it's just not going to last, is it? If I don't upgrade my gearbox for Spain, am I going to have troubles? I'm going to have to do it for Spain, aren't I? That's so annoying. I'm going to put a new ICE in for Spain and a new MGUH and a new turbo. Other than that, do I take the gearbox? I'll take the gearbox penalty. Fuck it, why not? Right, next weekend. True, I can overtake it, Spain at least.
The new parts have arrived from the factory without issue.
Good.
They'll be fitted to the car in time for the next session.
It's going to be a dry weekend, at least it's good. Complete 2 clean races. Okay. I can do that. If I'm going to take a penalty for the gearbox, should I just take a penalty on everything? Just for the sake. Do it all in one lump. What do you reckon I can get through the year without needing to? You reckon no? Okay. Alright, well, in that case, well, it's going to be the end of the stream anyway. In that case, we shall end it there. Well, I don't know that I'm going to be P20. That's the thing. I don't know that I'm going to be P20. I might be relatively... I might be able to get out... I might be able to qualify, like, P50... like, 12 or 13 or something. Yeah, no, I know I'm not. I mean, like, actually get, like, an extra allocation slot. Not change. I don't mean change from, like, IC1 to IC2. I mean, like, add a fourth. Just kind of cheat the system. So, obviously, I don't have to worry about actual money in real life. Like, add a fourth, add a third, add a fourth, add a third, add a fourth, add a third, and take, like, a 70 place grid drop penalty and then not have to worry about penalties again for the rest of the season. Right? I'm doing it. Joe, I can always decide after quali. Right. I'll decide after quali. But that'll be tomorrow. That's going to be it for this stream. Let me say thank you to everyone that subbed and donated, etc, etc. Let's have a look. Oh, a day ago, Bacon Boss resubscribed. Thank you, Bacon Boss. Thank you to Saul and Lewis and Crudy and Flying Piano Lid and Nick and Dan and Adam for the donation. Sam for the resub. Nick, Kalabu, Marked by Misery, Hunnell, Kieran, Cam, Nick, Callum, Nick. thank you, boys. I'll be streaming this tomorrow. I'll be streaming a FIFA 19 pack opening tomorrow as well. So do make sure that you're following the Twitch channel if you're not already. I'll tweet out when I'm going to go live tomorrow, probably mid-afternoon-ish. I'll probably do FIFA and then F1 again in the evening. But for now, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I'll see you later.